Welcome to India Media and Ashaiman News with me, Rizwan Asad. After 4 days of high drama, the coalition government, Congress JDS government falls. 14-month coalition government could muster only 99 votes, whereas the BJP has taken 105 votes. Immediately after the trust vote, Kumaraswamy went to Raj Bhavan and submitted his resignation to the governor, who told him to continue as a chief minister of caretaker chief minister till a new government is formed. Meanwhile, BJP is trying to form the government and seeing the pros and cons. B.S. Yediyurappa will be elected as a BJP LP leader shortly, and all talks and all pros and cons and legal aspects have been looked after. Because last time, Yediyurappa, when he was a chief minister, when he took oath as a chief minister, he lost the trust vote as he couldn't muster enough support and lost the trust vote within 6 days. Speaker Ramesh Kumar has upheld the disqualification of the MLAs, and the matter is in the Supreme Court and in Ramesh Kumar's hand. Now, the BJP is in dilemma to whether to stake claim or not, because if resignations are accepted, then BJP will have advantage, and if the resignations are not accepted, then BJP will be in the dilemma. Meanwhile, BSP Supremo Mayawati has suspended and disqualified her MLA who did not attend the vote of trust. The finance bill, which is pending and which has to be cleared before the 31st July, has to be cleared. In case the government is not being formed here and it comes under the president rule, the parliament will pass the finance bill. Meanwhile, in the IMA scam, Mansoor Khan, the fugitive, his custody has been extended to 26 July by the court, and the enforcement director has taken him to custody for further interrogation. According to sources, in the enforcement director, Mansoor has revealed names of top politicians, businessmen and officers. This is a sensation news, and the enforcement director is looking into the matter, and very soon they will be sending notices to all these persons whose names have been disclosed by Mansoor. When Mansoor was brought to the court, there was a lot of protest by the IMA investors, and they are always shouting slogans against him. The court has also directed the government to keep a competent authority under the KPD Act 2004 to foresee all the proceedings and to see, and they've already told the enforcement director that whatever investments and whatever properties they have seized to bring to the notice of the court. All the 23 accused who were arrested by the SIT are still in the SIT custody, and interrogation is going on. The SIT would be taking Mansoor very shortly after the interrogation of ED on 26 July. Keep watching India Media and Ashaiman News with me, Rizwan Asad.